Dr. A. Anthony Raj is an assistant professor in the Department of Physics at Loyola College, Chennai. He received his master's degree and PhD from Loyola College affiliated to University of Madras. At present, he is working at Loyola College where he is teaching since 2016. His main research interests are in the areas of nonlinear optics, terahertz technology and synthesis of nanomaterials. He has published 10 papers in international and national journals. He has participated and presented many papers in international and national conferences.
Welcome to e-lecture on electronics practical. In this practical, we are going to see introduction to test and measurement instruments like power supply, multimeter, signal generator, cathode ray oscilloscope, CRO, and digital storage oscilloscope, DSO. Apparatus required are DC power supply, multimeters, DC regulated power supply, signal generator, CRO, and DSO. First, we are going to see DC power supply. A power supply is a device that supplies electrical power to an electrical load. The primary function of the power supply is to convert electrical current from the source to a desired value of voltage or current and frequency to power the load. Hence, the electrical power supply is called electrical power converter. For example, power supply in the desktop computers and in many electronic consumers. There are various power supplies are available. For example, battery, DC power supply, AC power supply, linear regulator power supply, programmable power supply, switched mode power supply, high voltage power supply, and voltage multiplier. Now, in this practical, we are going to deal with basic power supplies like DC voltage power supply, AC regulated power supply, and DC regulated power supplies. First, we shall see DC voltage power supply. A DC voltage power supply is a device that supplies a constant voltage to a load. This is the DC voltage power supply of 5 volt source. This power supply uses AC main electricity from the wire. It employs transformer to convert the high AC voltage into a desired low value of AC voltage, which then it is passes through the rectifier, which rectifies the output of the transformer low AC voltage to continuously varying DC voltage. And the DC voltages, which in turn passes through the filter, which filters all the AC electrical components and supplies the unregulated DC power supply. This is the DC power supply of 5 volt source, which consists of a positive terminal, and this is called a negative terminal. In this case, it is a ground terminal. Red is taken as positive terminal and the black is ground terminal. This supplies a constant voltage of 5 volt. Let us measure the voltage from the power supply. Using a multimeter, we can measure the output voltage from the constant power supply. The multimeter reads the output voltage from this supply to around 5 voltage. This is the AC regulated power supply, which uses AC main current as the electric source and employs a transformer to step up or step down the AC voltage to low or high. This is the 12 volt step down transformer. This transformer used to step down the AC power supply to 12 volt AC power supply. Now let us measure the output voltage from the transformer. The multimeter reads the transformer voltage 12 volt. This is the DC regulated power supply. A DC regulated power supply is a device that supplies constant voltage or current despite the factor, the variation in the input load current or voltage. Now this is the DC regulated power supply. We have the voltage control. This is the voltage control where you can change the voltages. This is the current control, and the output is taken from this terminal. The next instrument is multimeter. Multimeter is an electronic device that is used to measure various electrical measurements like AC voltage, DC voltage, AC or DC current. It is called the multimeter because it combines the functions of voltmeter, ammeter and ohmmeter. This multimeter consists of three parts: display parts, input knob and connecting probes. The display parts has the ability to display 4 digits and has the ability of displaying negative sign. This is the input knobs, which is used to measure various measurements can be done from this input knobs. It consists of 2 connecting probe, a red lead and a black lead. Now, this terminal is called common terminal. It is always used to connect grounded. Usually, black lead is connected to ground. To measure the voltages, resistor and frequencies, the voltage and ohm input jacket soap is used. For measuring the current from the multimeter, the current input jacket soap is used. In case of for measuring high value of current greater than the milliampere, that is 200 milliampere, the 20 amp power is used. First, let us measure voltage. To measure the voltage, connect the black lead to common terminal. Connect the lead lead to voltage ohm jacket soap. Set the selector switch to desired value, DC or AC. To measure the DC voltage, set the selector switch to 20 volt. Now I am going to measure the voltage from a DC power supply. For measuring current, connect the black terminal to common mode and the red lead to milliampere. If the current is greater than 200 milliampere, use the 20 amp jack circuit. Now, to measure the current, connect the leads in series in the circuit to be measured. Set the selector switch to 20 milliampere. Now, to measure the current in the circuit, open the circuit, connect the lead in series with the load to measure the current. For measuring current, the black lead is connected to common terminal, that is grounded, and the red lead is connected to milliampere input circuit. The leads are connected in series with the load where the current is needs to be measured. The multimeter measures the current as 0.15 milliampere. For resistance measurements, the black lead is connected to common, the red lead is connected to voltage bar resistance circuit. Set the selector switch to desired value of resistor. And the resistance is measured by connecting the lead across the resistor. The leads are connected across the resistor to measure the resistor value. The value of the resistor is found to be 0.979 kilo ohms, nearly equal to 1 kilo ohms. For continuity test, the selector switch is set to test mode and the leads are connected at the connector. When we connect the leads across the connector, the beeper sounds, which means the connector is electrically connected. Besides these measurements, the multimeter can also be used to test various other measurements like diode testing, transistor testing, and frequency testing. Next, we are going to see function generator. A function generator is an electronic test equipment used to generate different form of waveform over a wide range of frequencies. Now, different waveforms can be generated from this function generator: sine wave, sawtooth wave, and square wave. Now, this is the sine wave. Changing the waveform to sawtooth waves, then square waves. Now, these square waves can be varied to a wide range of frequencies. Frequency can be varied here. The frequency output is taken from this, and you can vary the amplitude in this knob. Cathode ray oscilloscope, CRO. CRO is very important electronic device. It is very useful to analyze the voltage waveform of different signals. The main part of the CRO is cathode ray tube. The figure is shown here. This is the cathode ray tube. It consists of heating filament, an electron gun. There is a deflection plate, both horizontal and vertical. And this is the fluorescent screen. When charged electrons are emitted, by heating the filament, by supplying a negative voltage, the emitted electrons are accelerated towards the screen and falls on the screen. The frequency and the amplitude of this signal in the fluorescent screen depends on the voltages supplied to these deflection plates. The CRO panel consists of mainly four controls: display control, vertical controls, horizontal control, and trigger control. In the display control, the intensity knob is used to for brightness of the waveform. The focus knob used to adjust the sharpness of the waveform. Now, in the vertical control, this is the amplification base. Use the voltage bar division control to change the desired amplifications. This vertical control consists of two channels, channel 1, channel 2. In the horizontal control, this is the time-based control given as section bar divisions. It is used to change the time period in the horizontal signals. Now, this is the internal calibration point where you can calibrate the CRO by connecting the input probes to. This is the calibration point, internal oscillator. You can check internal connection of the CRO. This is the dual mode where both the channels can be coupled together to get the display. The positions of the waveform vertically can be adjusted by this. And in the horizontal direction, this is the horizontal adjustment can be done with this knob. This is the trigger part. The default trigger mode for CRO is auto mode. This is the input coupling. Input coupling is used to couple one circuit to another. If the input signal is from the electrical circuit, then this input coupling can be made to AC or DC. This is AC. Now it is in DC form. To measure the amplitude, adjust this voltage per division and find the number of divisions on the vertical scale multiplied with this voltage per division reading. To measure the frequency, that is the time period of a signal, adjust this knob for a desired frequency. Count the number of divisions in the horizontal scale and multiply with the seconds per divisions reading. Digital storage oscilloscope, DSO. This is the dual channel digital storage oscilloscope analog to the normal analog cathode ray oscilloscopes. It consists of dual channel, channel 1, this is channel 2. Now pressing the channel 1, using this function you can change the various mode of DC or AC can be changed here. This is used for channel off and on. This function is used for which probe used to be connected. In this case, I am using 10x probe. This is the calibration probe where you can internally check the frequency. Using the measuring mode, we can measure the various frequency and time period. RMS value can be measured in the digital storage oscilloscope. The difference between CRO and DSO are displayed here. CRO uses, it is directly reached the analog voltage and display it on the screen, whereas digital oscilloscope reads the analog voltage and converts it into digital form before being displayed on the screen. CRO does not require microprocessor and acquisition memory, but DSO requires analog to digital converter, microprocessor and acquisition memory. The various other differences are displayed here. With this, we come to the end of this lecture. In this lecture, we have seen testing and measurements instruments like power supply, multimeter, signal generator, CRO and DSO. Thank you.